Good morning, students. Okay, here in continuation of last video, basic concepts in chemistry for first PC. One more important basic concept. This is one of the important basic concept for the first PC and second PC. Okay, NEET level also. They may ask one question. NEET level also. We'll see in continuation. What is the molecular formula? And one more is there, empirical formula. What is the molecular formula and an empirical formula? And how to determine the molecular formula by knowing the percentage of composition of an element? By knowing the percentage of composition of an element. We'll see in continuation. Here we have the some steps based on that step. We discuss. Okay, first, what is the definition of molecular formula? Molecular formula and empirical formula. Empirical formula. Okay, first I am taking one example. After that I will explain definitions. Okay, here already we know about that one. Molecular formula of glucose is C6H12O6. Molecular formula of glucose is C6H12O6. It is a fix. Okay, then see the definition. Okay, the exact atoms present in the molecule of the compound. Okay, we can't change these atoms. They never change. Okay, the exact atoms which are present in the molecule of the compound, we call as molecular formula. Glucose means it should have the 6 carbon atoms, 12 hydrogen atoms, 6 oxygen atoms. That is exact number. The exact number of atoms of a molecule present in a compound we called as molecular formula. What is the meaning of empirical formula? See here. Okay, here it takes simple number. Which is least? Here oxygen is least. Six is least. Okay, 6 ones are, 6 twos are, 6 ones. What you will get here? CH2O. We can't change this one into further. This is only simplest form. Okay, the simplest form of the molecular formula. The simplest form of the molecular formula called as empirical formula. The simplest form of the molecular formula simply we call as empirical formula. Empirical formula. Suppose, for example, you take sucrose. It is a glucose, na? What is the formula of sucrose? Okay, C12H22O11. Here also 11 ones. Okay, so nearly 1.1, 1.2. That means this is also one of the simplest formula of sucrose. What is the molecular formula of sucrose? C12H22O11. Okay, here this is the simplest form of the CH2O, is the simplest form of the, okay, here which one?
Sucrose.
So it is an empirical formula. Okay, here you take acetic acid, CH3COOH. Acetic acid. CH3COOH is called as acetic acid. Okay, right. Exact atoms present in a molecule. How many carbons are there? Here, 2 carbons are there. How many hydrogens are there? 4 hydrogens are there. Next, how many oxygens are there? 2 oxygens are there. Yes, na? 2 oxygens are there. These are the exact atoms present in a molecule. So this is called molecular formula of acetic acid. What is the empirical formula of acetic acid? 2 1s are 2 2s are 2 1s. CH2O is the empirical formula of acetic acid. Empirical formula of acetic acid. I think you understood. Okay, here molecular formula, empirical formula. Exact atoms present in a molecule of the compound we called as molecular formula. The simplest form of molecular formula, simplest form of molecular formula is called as an empirical formula. Okay, this is about the molecular formula and empirical formula. How to determine the molecular formula? Okay, here I want to write the steps. You need space. How to write the molecular formula? How to determine the molecular formula of the compound? By knowing the percentages of or composition of the atoms. Atoms. Okay. Here, how many steps involved here? Okay. Here, 5 steps involved. Okay, when we determine the molecular formula of the compound. First step, convert percentage of composition of atoms. Into mass form. Mass form into grams. They may give the 6% of carbon, 2% of hydrogen, 3% of hydrogen, like that. Okay, then those are converting into grams. And here the percentage of composition should be equal to 100. Suppose, for example, 60% A is there. Okay, plus. Okay, 30% B is there. Okay, 10% C is there. It should be A, B, C. These are the atoms. Okay, those should be the sum of those atoms percentage should be 100. Should be 100. Otherwise, we can't determine the molecular formula. Okay, in the examination point of view, they should give. Okay, 100%. They give, definitely they will be the 100% or 99.9%, 99% like that. Okay, 99% also we consider as a 100. Okay, this is the first step. What is the first step? Convert percentage of composition of atoms into mass form, in grams. Okay, here one more important point. What is that? The sum of percentage of atoms should be equal to the 100. Okay, then second step. Okay, convert mass in grams into the number of moles. Convert mass in grams of an atom into number of moles. What is the principle for number of moles? Yesterday we discussed. Principle for number of moles is number of moles n is equal to small n is equal to weight by molecular weight. Okay, what is the principle here? N is equal to weight of solute. That means weight of atom by molecular weight of atomic weight of atom. Atomic weight. Here atom. Atomic weight of atom. By using this principle, we will calculate number of moles of that particular element. Second step finished now. Yes. Then, third step. Here we will get some values. Suppose A is there, B is there, C is there. We will get the A number of moles. Here we will get the B number of moles. Here we will get the C number of moles. Okay, in those, all are not equal. One will be simplest. One will be less value. Okay, here we will get three values. In that, one take one less value, and divide all the values with that less value. With the that less value. Okay. Here, what I write here? Divide number of moles. Number of moles of an atoms. Yes. Okay. With least number of a number of moles. Least number of a number of moles. Okay. This is the third step. What is the third step? Divide number of moles of an atom with the least number of moles of an atom. ABC, we'll calculate here number of moles of ABC. Okay, suppose C, for example, C has least value. Divide the A value with the C value, B value with the C value, C value with the C value. We'll get the sum numbers. We'll get the sum numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that we'll get numbers. By using those numbers, here we'll get numbers. By using those numbers, write an empirical formula. By using those numbers, write the empirical formula. Okay, here, when we write the empirical formula, okay, you should follow CH format. Carbon should be first, then hydrogen, or oxygen, or chlorine, or any other atom. First, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. If other atoms are there, write chlorine, fluorine, anyone, nitrogen also. But you should follow the CHO format. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. This is the high basic format. Not as per me or as per you. It is a IUPAC format. And here, suppose sometimes, okay, here, number of moles will get 2.5 like that. How will write the empirical formula? If you get 2.5, okay, this is multiplied with the suitable number. Okay, not only one, you multiply the A 2.5, B, for example, B got 2 into 2, 4. Here 2.5 into 2, 5. Okay, next C also will get 2 na, 2 into 2, 4. Multiply all the number of moles, not only one. Okay, if you will get this type of numbers, 2.5, 3.5, okay, like that. For example, 3.3, if you get 3.3. 3.3, okay, multiply with the 3. Okay, 3.3 into 3, 9.9. 9.9 is equal to 10. You all multiply the all number of moles. If you have only one, anyone have 2.5, 3.3 like that, that multiply with the same number with the all. Then you make a simple number. Okay, here, after writing the empirical formula, okay, then write molecular formula. During the writing the molecular formula, first, here we have three steps. Okay, one is calculate empirical formula weight. Suppose, for example, you will get CH2O. Okay, calculate empirical formula weight. Carbon 12, hydrogen 2, oxygen 16. 16 plus 2, 18. 18 plus 12, 30. The empirical formula weight of the CH2O is 30. Okay, you should calculate the first step, empirical formula weight. After the calculation of empirical formula weight, divide molecular weight of molecular weight of molecule with the empirical formula weight. Okay, here you get the one value, that value we consider as a n. according to our NCERT, that value should be considered as a N. Then finally, molecular formula is equal to empirical formula into N. We get the molecular formula. Molecular formula is equal to empirical formula into N. You remember these steps, then we move into the calculation of or determination of molecular formula and empirical formula. What are the steps? 5 steps. What are those? First, convert percentage into grams. Should make the 100%. Second one, convert into number of moles. Mass into number of moles. Next, third, divide. With the least number of total number of moles. Then fourth one, write empirical formula. Fifth one, write molecular formula. In these 3 steps, what are those? One, calculate empirical formula weight. Divide molecular weight with the empirical formula weight. You will get the N. By using that number, write the number with multiplied with empirical formula, you will get the molecular. With zinc contamination, one problem. Just I will write the one problem and we will discuss. Remember all this. This is a compulsory question for 3 marks in PU point of view, and it is important for the NEET point of view or JEE point of view or CEE point of view. Just I want to write the one problem. Compound contains here 4.07% of hydrogen, 24.27% of carbon, and here 71.65% of chlorine. Its molecular mass, molecular weight, all those are same terms. Molecular mass 98.96. Determine empirical formula, and molecular formula. What is the problem? A compound contains 4.07% of hydrogen, 24.27% of carbon, 71.65% of chlorine, and its molecular mass is 98.96. Determine the empirical formula or molecular formula. First, step 1. What is the step 1? Convert percentages into grams and should make the 100%. Carbon percentage 24.27 plus 4.07 plus 71.65 is equal to 100. It should be 100. You count it. Definitely it will be 100. 75 plus 24, 99. Remaining will get 100%. That means, 100% now. Then you convert into grams. That means here 24.27 grams of carbon. Compound contain how much amount of carbon? 24.27 grams. You are converting percentage into grams as is. Next, what? 4.07 grams of hydrogen. 4.07 grams of hydrogen. Next, here 71.65 grams of chlorine. That means the compound contain 24.27 grams of carbon and 4.07 grams of hydrogen, 71.65 grams of chlorine. Okay, now this is the first, should make the 100 finish. Okay, we converted okay percentages into grams. Finish first step, finish now second step. What is the step two? Okay, convert grams into number of moles. Okay, how to convert number of moles? Number of moles is equal to, what is the principle? Number of moles is equal to weight by atomic weight. Here in that weight by molecular weight, here atoms now, so atomic weight. Okay, weight by atomic weight. Okay, here first number of moles of carbon, we are calculating number of moles of carbon. Okay, weight of carbon is 24.27 by atomic weight of carbon is 12. Okay, atomic weight of carbon is 12. Okay, 12 to the 24, here 0.21. okay, like that, for right. Okay, this is the number of moles. Number of moles. Okay, then number of moles of hydrogen. Okay, what is that value? 4.07 by 1. That means here we will get 4.07. Third, number of moles of chlorine. Okay, here what is the amount? 71.65 by 35.5. Okay, nearly 2.04, like that. 35 to the, okay, now 70. Okay, we get 2.04. Okay, here we got some values. Okay, number of moles of carbon is 2.04. Number of moles of hydrogen is 4.07. Number of moles of, okay, here chlorine is 2.04. Which is least value? Both. Okay, you take this least value and divide with R, you will get the sum numbers. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the, shall I move to third step? Okay, just I want to move into the third step. Remember this one. Okay, third step, step 3. What is the step 3? Divide. Take one least number and divide with R. Okay, here carbon is equal to 2.04, na? 2.04 by 2.04. Okay, is equal to 1. Next, hydrogen is equal to, okay, 4.07 by 2.04 is equal to 2. Next, chlorine. Okay, here 2.04 by 2.04 is equal to 1. Okay, by using these numbers, okay, here we got numbers now. Here if we get number 1.5. Okay, suppose for example here we got 1.5. Here we got 2, here we got 1. Multiply with suitable number. 1.5 into 2. Here also multiply. This is also multiply. Multiply with all numbers with same number. Okay, 1.5 is equal to 3. Here 4. Here 2. Should multiply like this. Okay, don't multiply only 1. Okay, here sometimes you are adding 2. We are not multiplying like this. ग्राम should multiply all, should multiply all, that is compulsory. Remember that one. Okay, here step 3 finish na. Step 4, what is the step 4? Write an empirical formula with carbon first, hydrogen then any other atom. If oxygen is there, you write oxygen. Okay, if any other atoms are there, you write like that. Okay, first empirical formula. Empirical formula. How many? First write carbon, hydrogen, chlorine. Three atoms are there. You write it. No oxygen. Okay. Carbon. How many carbons are there? Only one. How many hydrogens are there here? Two. Write CH2. How many chlorines are there? One. This is the CH2Cl is the empirical formula of compound. Empirical formula of compound. By using this empirical formula, we should write the molecular formula. Should write the molecular formula. How many steps present in molecular formula?
Three steps.
First, calculate the empirical formula weight. Empirical formula weight. What is the empirical formula weight? Carbon 12. How many hydrogens are there?
2.
Each hydrogen atomic weight is 1. 2 into 1?
2.
Plus chlorine? 35.5. How much? See, 35.5, 35 plus 2, 37. 37 plus?
39.
2, 39 plus 10. 49.5 grams we need sir, guidance like that. Okay, this is the empirical formula. What is the second step? Divide. N is equal to, here N, you get N. Okay, molecular weight by empirical formula. What is the molecular weight? 98.96 by 49.5. See here, 49 to the 98. Okay, remain, leave it this one. Okay, what is the n value?
2.
This is the n value. Then, third. What is the third one? Okay, molecular formula. Molecular formula is equal to empirical formula into n. What is the empirical formula? CH2Cl. Okay, CH2Cl, keep in a bracket, into, what is the n?
2.
Then write. What is the C? How many C into 2?
C2.
H2 into 2.
H4.
Cl into?
Cl.
Molecular formula of compound is
C2H4Cl.
This is the molecular formula of the compound. By knowing the composition. Percentage in percentage. Okay, what are the steps involved here? 5 steps. What are those? Very very important. All those steps are very very important. What are those? First step, convert percentage into grams. And should make the 100%. If sometimes, okay, they may give 2 atoms, rest of the atom is oxygen, rest of the atom is chlorine, like that mentioned. You remove, you are, add the those two values and subtract from 100, then you get the percentage of another atom. Okay, in continuation, I will give the some more problems like that. We'll do some more problems like that. Okay, second step. After the conversion of this one, after the conversion into grams, calculate the number of atoms. Convert into number of atoms by using which formula? Weight by atomic weight. Second step finish. Third step?
Divide.
Okay, divide. Divide. Okay, number of moles with the least number. Okay, fourth one. Write empirical formula. Then fifth one. Write, calculate empirical formula weight. 49.5. Okay, here, after second step, calculate N. Molecular weight by empirical formula weight. Empirical formula weight. Molecular formula is equal to empirical formula into N. Empirical formula into N. This is about the, okay, here, this is about the determination of molecular formula. Determination of molecular formula. Okay, just I will give one example. One problem here. You have to practice. Just practice. Otherwise, I will tell tomorrow. A compound contains 60% of carbon, 60% of carbon, 32% of oxygen, 32% of oxygen, 8% of hydrogen, 8% of hydrogen. Okay, determine empirical formula only. Empirical formula. Determine empirical formula. Don't do the fifth step. Okay, I didn't give here molecular mass. So up to four steps you can go.
Empirical formula.
Up to right. Just empirical formula. Okay? This is the problem. What is the problem? A compound contains 60% of carbon, 32% of oxygen, and 8% of hydrogen. Okay, I give simple numbers. Okay now, simple numbers for our understanding purpose. Okay, in examination paper they won't give like that 4 or 2 like that. They will give different numbers. Okay, here carbon atomic weight 12, oxygen atomic weight 16, hydrogen atomic weight
1.
Take 1. Okay, do problem and show me.